In this video, say AM radio that I made in the past, say 20 years ago or so, worked between say 7.65 kilocycles and 1.3 megacycles. And this video is only a vlog because I cannot say advice someone to make this radio circuit because of its properties. On the other hand, it's quite good, and especially the interesting thing is that we have here a Schlage tuned coil that works in that frequency band, say of 7.65 kilocycles up to 1.3 megacycles. You can see here that the wire is extremely thin. I made it and I tested it and it worked properly, etc., etc. So on the other hand, that's a good idea to make such a Schlage tuned AM radio, at least a tank circuit. And after that tank circuit, we have, at least I have made, used a field effect transistor. So that's here. This is the field effect transistor here. It's the BF245, but when you say look on other videos that I've made in the past, there is another field effect transistor that does the same job anyway. And there are, say, many videos on my YouTube channel where I use a field effect transistor in, say, the front end. And this is also a kind of front end in the front end of a shortwave radio. So let's stand somewhat still here to show the field effect transistor. And after that, we have an amplification here, made with a BC547B. Say that's a normal NPN silicon transistor. And it's set to its maximum amplification. So this is the high frequency stage here. And here we have the, say, amplification stage. Perhaps when I have time enough in this video, I want to, say, draw that out anyway. So kind of first stage, front end, and here that second transistor that amplifies very much, because with the way it is made, it is set to its maximum amplification. Sorry. And here we have the audio amplifier. And I will show the schematic. It's a very, very interesting 3-volt audio amplifier. That's here. It can only give out, say, 30 milliwatts. But this is, say, kind of very good circuit to, say, connect to a front end of a radio or whatever. Also to, say, certain audio circuits. And the good thing, or the strange thing, or the bad thing is that it is not a class B amplifier, So there is no relation between the magnitude of the input signal and the output signal. It constantly takes a certain current here. So it's a class A amplifier in a certain way, but it can work on 1.9 up to 3 volts, and that's good. Useful for, say, a headphone or a speaker, loudspeaker. I will pan over somewhat to show all the properties of this circuit, and I also will, say, show a part of the text that is related to this amplifier, and it's in my book Schematics 2. Quite popular, many people have bought it, so that's a very, very good thing. Anyway, so here the text. You can use it with a headphone, you can use it with a speaker. Like I told, that audio amplifier takes a kind of constant current out of the 3 volt battery or the 2.2 volt battery. And with these kinds of circuits, there are always kind of typical problems. Such a circuit can start to oscillate, then in that case connect a here between the positive and the negative a smoothing capacitor of say 1000 microfarad, and of course don't mount that 1000 microfarad capacitor directly to the 3 volt source. Due to the leakage, it can, say, leak out that, say, 3 volt battery, etc. So, this was more or less all to tell. Well, let's look again at this circuit. The good thing of this circuit that I made, say, 20 years ago, is that we use here slug tuning. That's visible here. The coil, the ferrite rod, that is, say, inserted more or less with the screw. Well, I have to get to another position, otherwise I cannot move that screw so that I cannot tune. And the important thing to tell is that in the Netherlands the medium wave band is completely dead. So I cannot receive here anything. There's only one radio station at the moment, say June 2021. That sends out music, etc. So, I cannot give a good demonstration. Perhaps they only transmit in the evening or in the night or whatever, or they are, say, disappeared for what kind of reason. So I push in now here the ferrite rod, so we go to lower frequencies. This is of course also a kind of reception. Anyway, I don't know what it is. Anyway, I of course search for, say, an AM radio station. And I've heard in the afternoon two radio stations with this radio, though very, very faint. So anyway, I'll stop this demonstration. I hope it was a little bit clear. The only say interesting thing of this TRF radio is that it works on 3 volts with a field effect transistor at its input to a slug tuned coil, and that we have here that say end amplifier that can say drive a small loudspeaker in the 30 milliwatt range, and that's made with 2 simple transistors. Very easy to find transistors. Well, that was all.